everyone. This is Renee Romeo of reneeromeo.com. Today's project is learning how to install a roof underneath your existing deck. Now, if you remember from a previous project, this space has already been screened in, so we've made it insect-free. But now we'd like to make it water-resistant. So anyone can do this that can operate a cordless or electric screwdriver or drill. And I'm just going to put two pieces of wood together here with a nice long screw, and then I'm just going to drive it through one into the other. Now if you could do that, you could do this project. So let's look at the anatomy of a deck and the anatomy of the new material that we're going to be adding to it to make it moisture resistant. So here's a traditional joist, and what this does is it holds up all the decking material above my head. Then I have two giant structural beams that sit a little bit lower than those joists, and that actually holds up all of the load for the deck itself. And then I have a little step down area too on my deck that is actually lowered in this area, and I'm going to offer you two different ways to actually adhere this new material to your decking surface so that you can actually run your water off in a way that makes sense for you. So we have not purchased an expensive underdeck waterproofing system, and we have saved literally thousands of dollars by not doing that. We've gone ahead by purchasing some simple building materials like pressure treated wood. So this pressure treated wood, and you have to use pressure treated wood here because it's going to see moisture, is 2x4 material that's cut down to whatever length we need it. We have 1x2 material that's cut down to whatever length we need it. We've also purchased some metal pole barn siding, and this comes in 16-foot lengths, and you can have it cut by your big box store and have it delivered as well, which is exactly what we did. This stuff is a little hard to handle if you don't have a trailer that's long enough for it. And we've also purchased some metal gutter system. So we're going to take all of these materials and really put it together to get the water exactly where we want it and away from where we don't. So the reason why we've added new 2x4 material to the existing deck is to create a pitch for this metal roofing to take the water and actually move it away to where we want it. And what that means for you is, in my case, I have 16 feet that I need to go across. So I start out at one end right at the top, and I'm going to pitch that down 2 inches by the time I get to the other end. So if you have an 8-foot deck, you'll start out at the top on one end and you'll pitch it down to your gutter system that'll be 1 inch below that. So it's kind of an easy way to remember it. But the thing is too, is that you can kind of see here, mine is pitching toward the house. Now, this is not the recommended way to do this. If you have a wood house or anything with vinyl siding, something where there's wood over on the existing wall where you're going to hang your gutter. In my case, we've debated about this for about a month, and the way that we've decided to do it is pitch it toward the house. The only reason, and I'm telling you the only reason why we decided to do this, is because we have a brick house. Now the brick house is naturally going to be waterproof, and then over the course of time, what we've done to take care of that is we've taken some Flex Seal and we've gone along the whole perimeter of the brick, and we've actually sprayed it with Flex Seal to really further protect that brick from any moisture that it's going to receive during a real heavy rainstorm. The water is going to pitch toward the house and probably hit that brick pretty hard. So we just want to give it an extra layer of protection from any additional moisture it's going to receive as a result of the work that we're doing here. So please, if you're going to be doing this, make sure that if you have a wood house or wood siding or vinyl siding, you're pitching it away from your house. Now you'll also see we also have gutters in place in this patio area on both corners of the patio that actually take the water off the roof of the house and move it out toward the pond in our yard. And so what we're going to do, we're just going to tap into this, and we're going to take all the water that's going to be falling on the decking surface and this new roof system and move that out to our pond as well. Now this deck was built 16 inches on center, and what that means is the middle of every existing joist is 16 inches apart. Makes it really easy to figure out pitch and exactly where you need to put your new 2x4s. So you see here, the new material that we've added, we've had to cut around these lowered beams. So you'll see here, once you get to a certain area, you'll be able to run that 2x4 structure all the way from one end of the deck to the other. But if you have an area like this where you have to cut out for an obstacle, you have to be extra careful to line these two surfaces up with a level, making sure that it's going to be nice and even all the way down the entire length of the new roofing system so that it looks absolutely perfect. So this new support system that we've made for the metal roof is created out of nothing but 2x4s. And you'll see we've got a 12-foot length here, and it's got four hangers cut out of 2x4s as well. These are about 10 inches long each. And the way that we've actually constructed this is here, if this is your 2x4 and this is your hanger, we're making this like an L. So this is actually flush along this surface. This is going to get adhered to the existing joist just like that and screwed into place and screwed into place. But when you screw into place together, we've actually constructed this on the floor. It makes it a lot easier, and then we can just kind of lift it and screw it in from the side. So that's exactly how we did it, and that's exactly how you could do it too. So in order to run a gutter system, you also have to have the correct pitch, and it's the same exact pitch as you use for the metal roofing. So if it's 16 feet long, which is what mine is, you're going to pitch it 2 inches from the very center of the back wall to this gutter, and from the very center of the back wall to the other gutter. If you've only got 8 feet, it's 1 inch for every 8 feet. So we're using gutter straps, and this is a really great system because we don't have fascia board here that'll actually be able to go in through the front of the gutter into the back and into the fascia board. We needed another system. This is usually used for attaching to roofing. And so what we're doing is we're actually taking the strap, we're setting it at about 1.5 inches below where the roofing is going to sit, and we're attaching this little strap piece here, a little clip that's going to actually clip directly into the top of the gutter. So this is just going to set right inside, and then we're just going to push it in, and it's going to hold it nice and firmly in place, just like that. It's going to sit just like that, and the roofing material is going to come up like this, and the water is just going to flow directly into that gutter. So the last thing I'd like to show you are two dead men that we made. Now these two tools make this job so much easier to hang the metal roofing. And you know what? We've gone ahead and attached some toweling to it to make sure that we don't scratch any of the new metal roofing. And instead of telling you how it works, let's go ahead and show you. So if you're interested to see how this project turned out, tune in next week because there's so much more to see. We're going to share with you what fasteners we use on the metal roofing to make it waterproof, how to install fascia board to hide any areas that might step up or step down in your underdeck area, the secondary way of actually attaching the metal roofing to your joist system that's existing, how to finish off your gutter system and then attach it into an existing drainage system. So there's tons to see, and this is Renee Romeo of reneeromeo.com. I hope you join us and see what it looks like.